Brazen, that's the word police use to describe the bold determination of the suspect now that another woman has been attacked near Waldo.
It is the fifth attack in the last 5 months, this time at Rock Hill Road and 69th Terrace around 1:30 a.m. It's a situation that is changing the lives of the victims and the families around them. We have team coverage tonight with Maria Antonia in the neighborhood where this latest attack occurred, and Michael Mahoney is in the Waldo Business District. We go first to Maria for the latest on this case. Maria?
Lara, they call this the Armor Hills area outside of Waldo, but close enough. Behind me, the scene of the crime. And if you look back there, you see some equipment and some orange fencing that police put up in an area where they were digging earlier today. They spent the entire day digging, looking for evidence. And we don't know specifically what they were looking for or if they found anything. What we do know is that the attacker in this case got into the victim's house through an unlocked window. They've been using equipment that can cut into metal like a pipe. As people stop and stare, people who were already sticking together even before the latest victim, a 33-year-old home alone, woke up around 1:30 to find a heavyset man.
There's something going on for safety. We email each other. Something suspicious happened last night. A friend of mine told me XYZ, you know, be on the lookout. So we've just been on a heightened alert.
I'm looking at personal protection, a mace or tasers or something like that. I take kickboxing, thinking that would be enough to build my confidence and empowerment.
They're taking more precautions. One family, they've bought some a weapon.
We're into the neighborhood watch. Maybe the old-fashioned sign up for an hour or a couple hours in the night. And I was just talking to some neighbors about doing that. So we're going to get going on that and see what we can do to stop this person.
Now, we are told this latest attack went on for about an hour and a half. Another reason why police think it's the same attacker: they say the physical description they were able to get from the latest victim matches that description they got from earlier victims. We're in the Armor Hills area. Back to you.
All right, Maria, thank you. And we have that description for everyone. So far, it is a black man, 30 to 40 years old, about 6 foot, 250 pounds, bald, with acne scarring on his face, a deep, smooth voice, and bad breath. If you see someone matching this description, call the Crime Stoppers Tips Hotline.
The news of another attack so close to the Waldo neighborhood is being met with dread tonight. People who live and work there had hoped this was ending. KMBC 9's Michael Mahoney has been in that neighborhood today. Michael, what have you found out?
Well, this easygoing neighborhood, Larry, is on alert. Now, they may not be afraid, but when you talk to business owners and folks around here, they are certainly tense.
As one merchant put it, there are two Waldos. One with the stores and shops that let residents fill most of their needs close to home, and then the bars and restaurants that fill the district's nightlife. And both Waldos are now bothered by an intruder.
I know a number of people who are concerned. Somebody whose husband went out of town and she didn't want to stay in her house alone.
I know somebody that's renting out their house to other people and moving into Kansas in an apartment.
It's not panic, but there's a little bit of heightened fear.
When the attack started in late January, there was a fundraiser at Tom Dryling's bar here. Kennedy's.
We raised $5,000 through our fundraiser on February 6th, and the tips hotline has another $1,000, so that's a $6,000 reward.
But so far, no arrest, even though this is a business strip in a part of Kansas City populated by familiar faces.
That's why I'm surprised this guy hasn't been caught yet, because this is a very, very tight-knit community.
Dryling says his business has not been hurt, but he and others are now being more cautious. For instance, Kennedy's walks unescorted women to their cars now at night. And Hannah Schultz, who works here at Kennedy's, has changed her routine.
Like, I would walk around this neighborhood in the middle of the night before this started.
But not now.
No, definitely not now.
So things remain tense here in the Waldo area, especially after the news is now spreading of the latest attack. We're in Waldo, live, and now we're back to you.
Thanks, Michael. They're still taking donations for that reward fund. Contributions can be made to the Waldo Reward Fund at Metro UMB Banks.